गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी. आई एम डॉक्टर एस पी बेदी, प्रोफेसर इन एजुकेशन, एजुकेशन मैनेजमेंट डिपार्टमेंट इन दिस इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड डीन रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट. सो इन दिस सेशन आई विल बी जस्ट डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द व्हाट वी मीन बाय रिसर्च, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट, व्हाट रिसर्च इज एंड व्हाट रिसर्च इज नॉट. लेट्स बी एट द some type of common platform for these issues, and then we will be taking, after all, why do we need research, why should at all we go for research, some broad characteristics of that research, and what we mean by, of course it will emerge from the earlier ones, what is the quality research, and research can be classified on the basis of purpose also and on the basis of method also. If time permitted, I will go for just briefing about the different methods also. But if time is not there, I will stop at the purposes by research classification by purpose only. Because methods, number of methods, if you look into the course contents, it takes care of number of research methods in that. So let's first of all see what we mean by research. And for that matter, I would like to hear from the faculty at various institutions. Of course, I have some of the participants at this at our studio also, and I will also invite them to give their views for the things. So let me first of all let me hear from RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. Yes, what you mean by research? My session will be more of interaction session, because I know at number of centers there are PhD people, and I know because you are also actively contributing for research papers also, so some ideas are there with you already. So let me take the benefit of those aspects. So let me first of all invite from RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. Yes,
good afternoon madam.
Good afternoon.
So we are around 33 participants, and from our college around 26 are there. So remaining are from other colleges. Okay. Some of them are from government polytechnic colleges and government engineering colleges.
Good.
We attended the last pedagogy training program also. Some of 30 members have attended the pedagogy training program last 15 days back.
So we know each other, I think.
Yes.
Okay. So what you mean by research?
Research, I think I'll give to the participant. I am the coordinator.
Sure. Let me hear from the participants only.
Hello.
I'm
Dr. Raja, madam.
And
I'm the department. I am the assistant professor in RV College of Engineering Biotechnology Department.
Yes.
So the research, it's the getting the knowledge from the object. So there are four kinds of the getting the knowledge, madam. The first thing is getting the knowledge through the direct perception, through our sensory organs.
Okay.
Direct visualization. That's the first category of getting the knowledge.
Okay.
Second one is inferring knowledge. So we are getting the inferring knowledge about the object, whichever is not possible to understand about the object.
Okay.
That is second category. Third one is we are getting the knowledge about the object, particular object, for a particular time. That is experienced knowledge by our elderly people. Those who are already, they are having the documented evidences.
Okay.
The third category, fourth category is getting the knowledge through the trial and error methods.
Okay.
So these are all the four methods of getting the knowledge about the particular object for a particular time.
Okay. Okay.
So all the things we are going to be doing for the research. About the researched object, madam. This is my view of about the research work.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Rajan. If I have correctly heard the name, Rajan, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So thank you, Mr. Rajan. I won't comment as yet what we mean by it. Let me hear from some other center also. Let me go to MIET Jammu. Okay, Government Engineering College, Hassan. I am happy that Government Engineering College Hassan, they have joined last time for the research methodology course. There were some participants from the institution who could not join for that program. So let me hear from them. I think Mr. Chetan might be there from the Civil Engineering Department. I don't know who are the participants, whether they have joined in the program or not. Yes. Government Engineering College Hassan.
Hello, good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon.
Madam, according to my view, research is nothing but the systematic investigation of certain materials and establishment of those materials in some different kind of order with respect to facts and to get a new conclusion.
Okay. Okay. Madam, may I know your name?
Lalita, madam. I am from Kerpet Government Engineering College.
Lalita, very good attempt. Very good attempt in seeing. We will go beyond it. Can you, then anybody, for that matter, I invite the participants at the center also. Can anybody differentiate between what Mr. Rajan has said and what Madam Lalita has said? Is there any similarity or any difference between the two meaning of research? I don't want to go into any type of literary meaning of that or the exact definition of that. You might interpret the same thing in your own language and explain how these two aspects are differing, or are they the same thing? For that matter, let me invite Madam Isha. She is there in the our studio. How to means no okay, anybody from the center or from the studio?
Madam, Mr. Rajan has told what is how to do the different categories, the different
means. Okay,
but how to do?
How to do? Okay, we can say that the definition was more comprehensive, you want to say. Okay, he said that Mr. Rajan, you can correct him, but how you are means things are interesting. He says you have classified getting knowledge, information, then experiential type of thing, and trial and error. So he said he has taken it as different types of research, whereas she has gone into systematic, Lalita has gone into systematic way of investigating the things. Let me now just come to this point. Research is hunting for facts or truth about a subject. If I go into Mr. Rajan's interpretation of the things, I am getting knowledge maybe from any other things. So if say I maybe through sensing, maybe from by heat and trial, maybe by experience, and I would say maybe I consult books also, maybe I means have interaction with other people also, and I get certain facts about the things. Now, getting just the things is a one part of the research. It's not exactly the research. Now, adding to that, organized scientific investigation to solve problems, right? Now, when I'm just collecting information, it may not solve problems, right? I'm not focusing on that. Test hypothesis. We will have, just I will give some brief meaning of hypothesis. Of course, it will be dealt in the afternoon sessions. Develop or invent new products. As Madam Lalita said, that coming into something new also. So taking this in view, now we said scientific investigation. What we mean by this scientific investigation, first of all. Now, any type of scientific method requires two things, inductive and deductive thinking. I again go to you. what we mean by inductive. You may not relate it with the research. You just tell me the meaning of what we mean by inductive type of thing, inductive thinking. Anybody from any center, now they say, I'm not naming any center, any participant from any center can give me the meaning of inductive thinking. There are two things. You may tell any deductive, you may tell me deductive. Yes.
Going to large area from small area.
Okay. Going from
shrinking, like from larger area to smaller area.
Okay, from larger area to smaller area is so deductive.
You are testing, let's say 100, and you are concluding about one thing. That is deductive.
Deductive, okay.
And then you test, and you have the result of 10, but you apply it to a general.
Okay. Little bit, Priyanka, you are towards that. Little more. Let me have some explanations from any of the centers. Thank you, Priyanka, from the studio. Yes, any other center can come up? I think being engineers, you must have heard this word, inductive and deductive. Yes? Okay, I give you one hint. You have two situations. I just take Ohm's law, say. What we mean by Ohm's law? It's the relationship between voltage and current, right? Now I know the formula for it. Say it is V is equal to IR, right? Now one thing is I know V is equal to IR, so I establish a circuit and go on finding the values of by changing. Two aspects and see looking to the values of the third variable. Then say, I don't know what is Ohm's law. I change again two variables and find the things and see what has happened. Right? Now, these two type of things are different. One is going from, I know Ohm's law, right? And then seeing the instances, how it is going. Other, I don't know Ohm's law, but I'm finding the two by manipulating those two, V and I, and then I am seeing how they are related. Now, when I am going from, means I am not knowing and I'm just changing V and I and seeing how they are related. So this type of thinking is called inductive thinking, right? And when I know it, and then I am finding, then it becomes the deductive type of thinking. Now you will see this thing is happening everywhere. Say I make any assumption that the student, that the teachers, newly recruited teachers, they are using various ICT tools while they are teaching in the class. Now I see just it's my observation, and then I see that, okay, let me prove it through research that, is it my observation only or it is really happening that they are really using? So what I will do, it's my inductive, I will find different observed teachers and then find the relationship. In the deductive, what I would have done, I take the case that it is there. So I take the individual teacher, okay, this is newly recruited because he is newly recruited, he is using it. So this, the thinking goes opposite. Now in, it may be coming from any type of your observations. You may be having inductive, you may be having deductive. You are having certain observations of the environment. And on the basis of that, you make hypothesis. Now what we mean by hypothesis, they are just the guesses, right? Now guess may be true, maybe false, because whenever you see, say I go back to even Newton, he saw that apple is falling and say overnight he doesn't invented that law, gravitational law. It was he thought of certain thing, made certain guesses, and then proved that okay, this type of thing is happening. So this guess may prove to be right or wrong. We are not concerned about it because this is just the guess. Say I have lost my key. And I feel that, okay, at the end, I have went to Priyanka's room. So my keys must be with the Priyanka's room. I go there actually and I find keys are not there. Right? But that doesn't mean that my hypothesis, my guess was wrong. Guess was based on certain assumption. Now, this type of thing we are framing in our research also. Then, okay, we come to the implications of the hypothesis. You said that I made a hypothesis that, okay, all newly recruited teachers will be using ICT tools, right? Now, what will be the implications of that? That I will find certain people, look for those things among them. So I have made certain implications of that. I collected data on that, right? I selected specific testing situations. Then I saw really what it is happening. Now that the result has added to existing structure of knowledge that this thing happens or not. Point is, just observing that maybe you find any way, as Rajan said, that through trial and error you find certain thing. But once you find, you have found through trial and error, research says you have to prove it, whether it is generalizable or not. So you go beyond it. If say the information, anything is coming from, taking a very lay person type of example, because he mentioned that the information is coming from our culture or say maybe from others. So say, kehte na billi rasta kaat jaye to kaam nahi banega. Let me just test this hypothesis that, okay, does it really happen with me, with 10 people? If it's not happening, that it means it's not a generalizable type of thing. So point is, in research, we frame hypothesis, we collect certain information, and we test that information. That way, our research is systematic. It follows certain steps. Just see, they will be very logical in order. Understanding nature of problem to be studied and identifying the related areas of knowledge. Now, let me hear from you. How do you select the problem? How many of you are doing I see at least in my, in ETV studio only, there are two doctors are sitting with me. So, truly tell me how you selected your problem. Dr. Keshav and Dr. Sikandrao. Hanji, how you selected your problems?
We are seeing our surroundings.
Okay.
We have selected an area.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, so they are saying that they selected some area and from the surroundings, they thought of the problem. Let me hear from any of the centers. I now move to Sobhasari Engineering College, Sikar. Dr. Rathi is there. Dr. Rathi, will you help me in getting this information that how, if any of you, in any case, you yourself have done doctorate, how you selected your problem? Yes? If you are to select, Hanji madam, bataiyega. Yes, madam.
Hello.
Hanji, bataiye, madam, please.
Madam, Priya from ETV Engineering College.
Hello. Hanji, madam. Go ahead with this.
Hello. What is the question, ma'am?
Yes, madam.
Sir, ma'am, we want to make clear that how research methodology will help us in getting a proper way that we are teaching our goals to pursue our PhD in a particular topic.
Excuse me, madam, will you please repeat it? There is some problem in audio. हमें सुनने में ठीक रहेगा. इट्स नॉट ऑडिबल, क्लियर नहीं है. यस, नाउ इट्स ओके. या
in a particular subject, how how we can know.
If I am correct in interpreting what you said, the different two different use of different technologies, you yeah. make some survey and get the idea where you want to conduct the study. Am I right?
Because you were saying that so, but not a survey, we can get an idea that how we can move through the research in the
Little bit clear, but still not audible. I will again request you. We will come back to you again. Keep your this request is for the all the centers. Please keep your mic little bit away from your mouth so that it is more audible. Otherwise, it interferes with the what you say. Okay. Any other center who will like to means respond on this, how you select your problems for maybe you are guiding your ME students, right, at the at the master level, or you are guiding your students for PhD degree, how you make them select the problems?
Hello, is it audible, ma'am? Good afternoon.
I just pose a question. There was perhaps some problem with the problem. So we are back to the things. So reviewing, as rightly pointed by Dr. Kishan, Mr. Dharmendra Kumar from Architecture College, Engineering College here in the Chandigarh only. He is here with us in the studio. So he has rightly said that by reviewing the literature, we can come to know that that work has already been done. So there are different purposes of review, but one of these, this also helps you in knowing that whether your problem which you are going to investigate is not a duplication of the work of the others. Then once we have means framed hypothesis, then we collect information to then the analysis of the data is done. Then we finally draw conclusions and make generalizations. Now you see, our research has followed certain questions raised. Then the problem was identified, hypotheses were framed, data collection was done, and we tested our hypothesis, interpreted the results, and that may come up with the more new questions. And this thing goes on. Say, as our director was mentioning in the morning, that say green vehicle has been prepared here by under startup in our NITR, at our NITR. So there are further areas of research have emerged from there, how to means charging them and everything. So new questions have come, and we go on keeping this thing goes on in the research. Now, can I means formulate hypothesis before identifying the problem? Can I collect the data before identifying the problem? No, we can't do. Can I interpret the result without collecting the data? Why I am raising this thing? You see, it has followed a logical order for going into the research area. You can't change the sequence of the things. So that's how we say research is systematic. So there we to have seen two aspects: scientific inquiry, that is, it may follow inductive or deductive approach, and it will be systematic. Now you take any piece of research work in any area, maybe engineering, maybe non-engineering, you will see these two features will come up everywhere. So what we can say, research is the systematic process of collecting and analyzing information in order to increase our understanding of the phenomena about which are concerned or interested. So research will be always systematic. Right, there may be different definitions, but finally they means point these aspects in various definitions. Now I come to what research is not. Obvious answer is what research is, opposite of that is the what it is not. So let us see what research is not. Let me hear again from you. I missed some of the institutions. MM Engineering College Molana, are they there or no chance? Yes, let me hear from you what research is not. We just discussed. Your obvious answer can be what research is the opposite of that. But let me hear from you distinctly what research is. Yes, please, anybody?
Madam, good morning.
Yes, good morning.
This is Mohan Kumar Chauhan.
Yes, sir.
From Assam, Bangalore College of Engineering, Assam.
Okay, sir. Yes, right, sir.
Madam, can you recognize me? Actually, we were participated in IIT Kharagpur.
Okay.
Of course, in the last year.
Okay.
Yeah. Madam, about the research is not just merely collecting the literatures or data is not a research.
Very good, sir. Where you attended the PLAS program?
Yeah, in the last year in IIT Kharagpur, madam.
IIT Kharagpur, okay.
Yeah.
So might be, that's why I am having a very good response from your institution. Okay.
Thank you.
Good thing. So you can help develop certain things also. So, and one thing you said, the research is not just collecting the information. Very good. What else? What else you would like to add in that?
Or unless you not contribute something, new methodology, unless you a new concept,
okay,
ideas, that is also not a research.
My very good in putting these things, Mr. Chauhan. Thanks a lot. So when you say that some new concept,
yeah.
Now let me add there, if it is not tested, if that is
methodology,
then it will become a piece of research only. So idea may be new, concept may be new, but yeah, if it is not tested, then it will not be a research. So research is not, rightly said by you, research is not just information gathering. I collect a piece of work from one book, another book, third book, and put it in one go. This is not a research.
Yeah.
Then gathering information from these books, magazines, anywhere, because these things are not contributing to any knowledge, then we say research is not the transportation of facts. You take a number of facts from one source and then you put it in the other form, in a different form, then again it's not a research. Means for that matter, I would say when we will be discussing quality of the research, research is not when you plagiarize the things. You take just work done by one person and put it in your name and publish, this is not research. Rather, you will end up with the n number of problems if you dare to do such type of thing. Now I come to why, after all, do we need research? Why should we conduct research? I will come at the end to the RV College of Engineering. Let me have hear from Indraprastha Engineering College, Ghaziabad. They are not connected. Okay. Ganga Institute of Technology and Management, Karlana. Puneet Garg might be there. Then you go to Government Engineering College, Hassan. Yes, please.
Madam
Lalita, you made a very good point last time when we were interacting with you.
Yeah.
So we will again like to hear from your center.
Yes, to understand the concept in a very comprehensive manner.
Okay, to understand the things in a comprehensive manner,
Yeah.
That's why we need research. Okay, any other idea from your center?
To add the new ideas, new methodologies.
Add new ideas, new methodologies. Good. Sir, may I know your name?
Madam?
May I know your name, sir? May I know your name, sir?
You have yeah, Mohan Kumar Chauhan, madam.
And yes, sir?
Mohan Kumar Chauhan.
Mr. Mohan Kumar.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. So let me hear from the center also, from the girl section, Isha Priyanka. Yes. No. Why do we need research? Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Mohan. Hanji. Let me hear from you. Fine, very good. So Priyanka is saying to find solutions to the problem. Very good. Let me hear from the other side also. Gaurav, what you would like to say? Yes. Modifications. Very good. Modifications of the earlier work. So point is, generally we think that research is only for taking M.Tech or PhD degrees only. Of course, this is at the top because most of the focus is for that matter only, but it goes beyond it that we need it. Some of the points you have rightly said, to provide some solutions to some certain problems, we to investigate laws of nature. Let me hear, have you investigated any laws of nature through the research? There are plenty of them. Newton's law means all these laws which we will be finding in the basic sciences, they are coming from, they are the laws of nature only. To make new discoveries, rightly said by some of you, to develop new products. You see, if you go to the ancient time and come till now, you will see there are three changes in all fields, and that has been well elaborated by Dr. Tulsi in the morning. To find any field, and you will see a lot of research being done in that particular area. Now, here I would like to say something. It's not that you always come up with some new product which is tangible, that is research. Even if you find certain way to carry out anything, any procedure, any process which is cutting costs, that also is a research, because that helps a lot in number of things. It may be energy saving, it may be any aspect, wherever it is coming, it may be even time saving. Any type of thing which is saved will also be called as a piece of research only. To improve our life, you will see that number of researches, they are done just to improve the quality of our life, quality of our living. If we say right in the long old age days, stone cut wo karke you used to means create fire, and now you see the where we have reached. So point is, to improve our quality of life, transportation, everywhere you see that there are a lot of research is being done. And not only that, it is the human desire. You look into the child, that child will say, what is there in the mobile? Right? No, he is not able to see any person. So curiosity, what is there? So this type of thing again, because it means right from our childhood, we have that type of desire to do some such research work, which of course helps in giving new products, new discoveries, improving our quality of life and all. So we do research to fulfill human desire. So let's not restrict our research to PhD and masters. And so that's the reason we should focus, even for masters and PhD degrees, we should focus on finding certain research work which is of use to the human beings at large. Then what we mean by high quality research? Scope and limitations of the work to be clearly defined. This is very important. We do conduct research, but at number of times, the findings are, the generalizations are applicable to certain contexts only. Now, that type of things, that type of limitation should be spelled out right in the is your piece of work itself. It should not be that you took it that, okay, this limitation is there, it will go. No, all those things should be highlighted, scope, because you can't, I have seen number of vehicles are produced, they say that, okay, it will run at this type of speed. But if you look into the road conditions, those things won't work. So under what context that the things can be used, that limitation should also come out in the research work. Then the process to be clearly explained so that it can be reproduced and verified by other researchers. If I go to the basic thing, Ohm's law. Now Ohm's law, anybody anywhere can test it. So you are to explain everything that under what so that even for at times they test the things. That okay, is it really done by the individual or not? So in the research work itself, it should be written that under such conditions it can be reproduced and it can be verified. It may be the management case, it may be the as engineering case. Thoroughly planned, that is as objective as possible. Then we will say, what is bad research? I would focus this also. Opposites of all good research, of course. Plagiarizing other people's work. This is means a lot of people are doing it, and now there are number of softwares which will come up and tell you how much and which line, which para they have lifted from which source. So this type of thing, there are certain limits. Of course, I'm seeing most of these universities have not given the acceptable limit for that, because some plagiarism means if you put other person's work in your own words, then and quote properly refer also, then it's not coming under the plagiarism. But certain things are allowed also, because you are not making the things afresh, you are not giving any basic law to the system. So naturally, you are, when we are saying that we are reviewing the literature to see the gaps and then find the another problem, you are getting some threads from the earlier work. Now point is, you are to quote that work, reference that work in your research piece, then it won't be plagiarism. But picking as it is plagiarism, and I won't say it is bad, I would say it's worst type of research. Then falsifying data to prove a point. Let me here take example of research from the social sciences. I have seen certain people will say, okay, this thing I have seen in my class, and it should be proved also. I see that, say, number of ICT tools have come, and we feel that use of those tools will help in developing, will change the learning level of the students. Will make it, means achievement level will be changed. Now, this is my point of view, that it should do it. Logically, it looks like that also. I have seen what people will do. Say they conducted the research, and the thing which was in my mind, that has not been proved through the analysis. Instead, that this relationship, it should have significant effect on changing the achievement, it has not changed the achievement. Now, because the researcher feels that it should be there, previous research also says that it should be there. So what they do, they start manipulating the data. It's very easy to manipulate the data, and they falsify the data to prove that because others have said that it should be there, in my research work also it should also come out like this. This is a wrong notion. When you make a hypothesis, right in the beginning I said, your hypothesis is a guess. Of course, there is some logic in that. Logic may be that your observations around are like that it should happen. It may be that review is telling that these under such, with usage of such type of things, this should happen. But if actually it has not happened, then the tendency is, I'm sorry to say here, there were examiners also, they said that it should be there because all research is saying, in your case, why it is not there? So I thought that it is just probing, that the student should answer and defend his case. But to my surprise, the research, the examiners pass means expecting that why it, how it has happened. It should not happen. But in researches, don't feel that, okay, this should be there because it's my observation. No. Research, when you have means collected data, analyzed data, and of course, the steps taken should be right. If you are missing certain points, say you have to teach two means classes with different methods, and in the class where you are taking ICT tools, the motivation level is very low. Now some other factor has started contributing to this. Now that might have become the reason that the your results have come in a different way. So the design for the conducting the research should be right one. But once it is right, you have taken all controls, then the results are against what you thought of, then don't falsify the data to prove what you thought that it should come like this. It's a bad research then. Misinterpreting information and misleading participants. This again means relates to falsifying data, means you want to prove your case. So you start building that type of thing that, okay, misrepresent the data somewhere and means what you thought that should come. So you start proving those things. Research characteristics, let me, I will just, because research characteristics will originate, come from what I have already discussed. I will just means read out them. This originates with a question or problem. This requires clear articulation of a goal. I would say when you are writing statement of the problem and are giving objectives, that should be clearly written. It means a language which you are using in framing, that should be correct. That should not have different meaning for different people. You should take care these points while writing the objectives. Follow specific plan or procedure. That also is laid down right in the beginning. And while conducting the research, that has to be followed also. Generally, it is required that your main problem is divided into sub-problems. Now, this will depend upon the nature of the problem. If it requires like that, then you have to means take care of that. You may have to pilot test certain things. It will all depend what type of the total problems you have taken. Then you are to frame hypothesis. At times you have to make certain assumptions also. It's not wrong to make the assumptions, but it is wrong that if you don't specify those assumptions in the research report, or you think of those assumptions after the research, that should not be there. Just when you are beginning the research, think of what type of assumptions you are making. Requires collection and interpretation of the data. Of course, it's there. So this was all about the research. And then we are moving to the classification of research. I mentioned right in the beginning that classification will be based upon the purpose, and it will also can be based upon the method. So let me just take first of all research classification on the basis of purpose. I have written here educational research, but for that matter, I would say even the scientific research, there is again basic research, there is again applied research, and there may be some instances of, because context is at times happens even in those areas also, action research also. More it will be in the social sciences, action research. So let's first of all see what we mean by the basic research. Let me again hear from you what we mean by the basic research. Okay, let me just give you a hint of that. Developing a new theory. Now I can hear from you what type of things will come under that. Develop new theory, law, anything. Dr. Keshav, you said your area is plastic and broadly it is chemical engineering. What was your area of research?
Synthesis of new polymeric.
Very good. Synthesis of new polymeric. It means it is going towards the basic type of research, because there, because you means found out certain ways which can be applied to some other situation when you are using those polymers. Now if you look into, say, Archimedes' principles, Newton's laws, you may go for kinetic energy theory, magnetic effects of materials, currents. All these things are going towards the new, I would say, in the basic sciences, research is more of the fundamental type of research is there. You are not using that itself. Say when you say Newton's law of motion, the law has added something to the existing body of knowledge in that discipline, but its use can be in other areas. When we say uses in other areas, then it starts going into the area of the applied research, right? So here, you can be having n number of examples in the education and in other social sciences, say management area also. You, Isha and Priyanka, what was your area? You are from management. Very good. So Isha and Priyanka are here in the studio. I will like to know from them, give me any example of the fundamental type of research in management. Say, if I say, take the case of education research, Skinner's theory of reinforcement, it's the basic type of thing. Skinner theory. Likewise, there are basic theories in the management area also. Very good. Now these theories, they are the basic type of things. Mastery learning theory, that is a basic type of thing, right? Anybody in the various centers who are from the management area? Any center who will like to interact for sharing in the especially, I would say, management area, because some of the basic research for sciences I have already given certain names, certain ideas. Let me hear for the management area. Yes. Any center? Anybody is coming up? Monica, aa raha koi? Actually, main name call karti hu na, to wo center jo hai na, wo aate nahi hai abhi aage na. Okay. There is Meenakshi Institute of Technology, Bangalore. NI, shuru mein kya padhta hai? I don't know. It's Nidhi Meenakshi. NIT. NIT Meenakshi Institute of Technology. Yes, please. Yes, please. Are you able to hear my question? Any person from the management here in this institution?
Management area.
Any student from the management area? No? No person is from management area? Okay, Sobha Sariya, Engineering College Seeker. Sobha Sariya, Engineering College Seeker. Okay, MIET Meerut nahi juda, jud gaya tha baad mein, jud gaya. Okay, MIET Meerut. Yes sir, any person from management area or anybody who can give example maybe from sciences for the basic type of research? Sir, any example for basic type of research? I was asking for management, but you can give from the any area, any discipline. Yes, sir.
Can you hear me, ma'am?
Yes, yes, sir. Very clearly.
I'm from MIT Meerut.
Okay, sir.
Maslow's hierarchy theory was there. In that, you can have the researches. Then Fisher effect is there.
Very good. Very good. That's what I was thinking of. Motivation theories are there. They are the basic ones, right? Now, whether the results of those theories can be applied to any given situation, say I want to motivate employees. Now, this application comes to the applied area. If I say I can motivate students, then it comes to the application of that theory for the applied kind type of research. So basic research will be adding some new theory. It may be Charles' law, Boyle's law, any type of basic laws, properties of metals, non-metals, any type of thing. So here you will see there will be always rigorous control of variables. If at any point you have to control the temperature or pressure, especially for fundamental sciences, you have to control those things, otherwise the results will be different. And they are generally conducted in the laboratory settings. Then you have the another type of research is the applied research. In the applied research, the purpose is testing of a theory or solving some practical problems. I observe that, okay, my students are not motivated. Now, what I feel that how to motivate them, I devise certain ways. Okay, if I do this thing, they will be motivated. So I take two classes. One class I motivate, the other class I don't motivate, and then I see the results. I say that ICT tools, which are coming maybe from the basic research, I say that use of these things in the classes will improve learning. So again, I form two groups and look into those things, the effect of that. So in the applied research, the whatsoever is coming from the fundamental basic research, we are applying those things to the certain situations. And beauty of the applied research is that you are able to generalize the findings. It's not that it is true for in Chandigarh and it won't be true in Ambala or in any other city of that. And for that matter, if I look into the basic sciences, fundamental sciences, for say when I was saying Ohm's law, Kirchhoff's law, you see that in engineering, if I come to the engineering area, distribution of electricity that comes from that. If I talk about the this magnetic effect of currents, fans and everything, you are using, applying those concepts and further you are coming. Properties of metals may be coming from the basic, but keeping in view those properties, you are finding what type of materials, what type of metals can be used, say for boilers or for aeroplanes and everything. So point is, all those things which are coming from the basic research, you are applying to the certain situations. In this, we also have the developmental research, wherein we may go for the designing of the new type of curricula, effective type, the products are done. Created. It may be in terms of instructional material development, it may be in terms of curriculum designing, but point is, again, you are to test them. Then, and the generalizations of applied research, they are widely applicable. You can generalize the findings to various situations. I am coming to the last type of research, which is based upon the purpose. The difference, major difference between the applied and action research will be that findings of action research, they are not that generalizable. They are context-based. Only for that area, they are applicable. Say, to solve immediate problems, that's why it goes like that, to solve immediate problems for local situation only. Say, there is a particular industry. There is a problem of relationship, communication problem is there. Now, that communication problem may not be there in another industry. It is specific to one industry only. So we don't talk about the other things. So these findings cannot be generalizable to the other situation. In my class only, there may be three sections, and only in my class, the nature of students is, background of students is like that certain things are not working which I want to teach. The methods through which I want to teach. So I devise certain different methods to cope up with those type of situations. But now I can publish that work also. Why I am focusing on the action research? These are mandatory, and I think it will improve the teaching learning and the findings which you report in various journals. Other teachers will be able to have view of those things, and which will add to your professional development also. you find certain thing is working in your classroom situation, you can means conduct a small study and find out the solutions. Now, as I said, the findings are not generalizable. But when the other person goes through that, if the context is same, if the nature of situation is same, that person can use, or that person may change certain aspects of it, keeping in view the his need, and again conduct that type of study. So in action research, we solve immediate problems only. And here, the person who is having the problem is also the conducting the research also. So that person better knows everything about the situation. So this type of research, action research, is becoming very popular nowadays. And it may happen that certain products which come into the market, looking into the particular market, certain design components, at times they have to be changed also. The needs for each area, say hilly area, non-hilly area, may not be the same. So accordingly, you have to work out certain things keep for a particular product so that it is usable in that locality also, which might be when you were conducting the study, when you invented the product, at that time you were not knowing clear about it. But later on, when you find that, okay, certain such type of situations are there where our product will not work, you make certain changes to meet that requirements. Now, that changes are restricted to that localized area only. Right? Maybe in Leh, you need a different type of thing. But the same thing may not be true for the other areas. Even within even J&K, they may not be means equally workable. So action research is the more, that's why the generalizations are not that much as compared to the applied research. Applied research findings are more generalizable. And basic research, if you look in, that is applicable to different areas, more wider generalization. When you come to the applied, generalization is more, but as compared to the basic, but action research, you are restricted in the. So action research is more of the collaborative nature also, and the person who has to use the solutions, that we can, they those persons are generally form part of those things. Say when you are, say, changing the product, keeping in view the, say, conditions of Leh, then what you will do, you have to take care of those customers in view. You may sit with them, work with them, and then find out certain solutions. So that's how these things differ. So researcher implements the findings of research. Then I said the other classification of the research is by method. I will not go into detail of these because descriptive research under historical research, of course, talks about the past events. Maybe what type of means trends in dresses, technical education may be there in the past. Descriptive is of three types: survey, content analysis, and case study. If I talk about the descriptive, it talks more about the current situation. If you under this, when I am talking about the three methods, one is the survey type of research. So you want to investigate what is the perception of students regarding their evaluation system, maybe towards their instructional processes being followed in the institution, teachers' attitude towards the technical education. It can take off the things which are prevalent in this. Under this, the other form is the content analysis. There we make these things are given in the in our PPTs also, and it will be with the in the material which Dr. Tulsi will be sending to the different centers also. I think Dr. Tulsi might have given the course material right here for the participants who are attending here. To others, she will be sending the soft copy of the things. So descriptive, under content analysis, we analyze the communication. Now communication may be quality of e-content, maybe quality of question papers, anything can be there. Now for analyzing that quality, you formulate certain, why it is research. You can question that why you are calling content analysis as the piece of research, because you certain frame certain dimensions, collect information on those dimensions from different experts, then analyze the data and see what type of things are happening. So that, because it is following a systematic procedure, again forms part of the research. The third is the under this comes the case study. So this will be discussed day after tomorrow by Dr. Tulsi. Correlation and ex post facto, of course, I will be taking at one point of means maybe day after tomorrow. Then experimental research will also be discussed in detail. These methods will be discussed in this course. So I'm not going into details of these things. So with this, we break for the lunch and reassemble at 2:15 in the for the next session on selection of problem. Thank you, everybody.